New tonight, Florida Fish and Wildlife just identifying the young man killed in a boat crash here on Davis Islands yesterday. Action Air 1 flying over the scene. And tonight, the man who tried saving both the man and the woman on that boat is speaking to ABC Action News. Let's head out to our Serena Fazan. And Serena, he says there was an obstacle no one could have ever imagined.
Jameson, it was her hair, the woman's hair. It got caught in the propeller. She's in the hospital tonight. In the meantime, that Good Samaritan is still struggling with what happened in these waters. Jay Young hasn't slept. He's scraped and bruised.
I have a feeling this happened either when I was trying to get her on the rocks or when I was trying to get her hair out of the prop. I really don't know when that happened. The fiberglass got my, I know that was the fiberglass.
But the physical pain doesn't matter. It's the images of this small 15-foot boat crashing that's causing him the most anguish.
When I saw the boat approaching the pilings, I can't believe this guy is doing this. And he swerved at the last second, and the boat hit the piling and glanced off. He went into the water immediately. The girl was still in the boat.
Without a second thought, he took his shoes off and jumped in, first trying to find the man, 22-year-old Keith Rohde. But Jay didn't have long to look for him.
Again, the boat was going in a circle, in a tight circle. Well, she just jumped off.
And when Jay got to her, to his horror, she was stuck under the boat.
She had longer, kind of curly hair. It was very wrapped around the propeller blades and down in the hub, and I was just really just yanking at it to try to get it out of there because we had to get her up above the water. I yelled at somebody at the shore, is there anybody with a knife? And nobody had anything, so it was just pulling what I could.
He finally got her free and to where paramedics were waiting.
But she was breathing again by the time we just got her to the rocks. I was amazed. I couldn't believe it.
Officials are not releasing the woman's name. We do know she's at Tampa General Hospital, but we don't know how she's doing. FWC is investigating. Reporting live in Tampa, I'm Serena Fazan, ABC Action News.